Wealth, wealth, and wealth once again. What's up, 23% Nation? This is your man, Coach D. Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm back with day 7 of the 23% challenge, which happens to be Wealth Day. Now, of course, I want to address what Wealth Day is all about. Plus, I want to give you a little bit of more information. So guys, let's go ahead and dive into a few questions that are going to make Wealth Day and perhaps any other question that you may have about the 23% challenge diet just a little easier to digest. So first, let's start off with, what is the 23% challenge all about? Well guys, it's a monthly 7-day wellness program that is designed to help improve your health, your wealth, your relationships, and it also helps to save good old planet Earth. Now remember, I said monthly. So that means that it's every single month. Now it's only 7 days, and it happens to be the first 7 days of every month. So it's always the first through the 7th of each and every month. Our next question is, what is Wealth Day all about? Well guys, Wealth Day being the 7th day of the challenge is really a day that we are aiming to improve one specific dimension of wellness, and it happens to be termed our intellectual wellness, which is really all about seeking new and different and maybe even difficult challenges. It also involves finding solutions to problems and also solving problems that you currently have or maybe ones that may come up in the future. Now, as far as your duties on Wealth Day are concerned, well, get ready to have a whole bunch of fun. Guys, Wealth Day is all about you creating and actually carrying out what I like to call a wealth experience. Now, you may be wondering, what in the world is a wealth experience? Well, number one, let's look at the definition of the word wealth, which simply means to have an abundance of anything, right? So, on your wealth experience, you basically are going to do something that gives you the feeling of being wealthy, of being abundant, of being prosperous. So, if you're wondering, what can I do for my wealth experience? Well, guys, right now, I want to give you a few examples that I believe can really help make your Wealth Day successful. So, let's say that you're the type of person who enjoys cars. Well, I want to encourage you to go visit your favorite brand of car. Go to the dealership, talk to a salesperson about the car. Learn the ins and outs, maybe even take it for a test drive, right? Next, some of us may enjoy very fancy and beautiful homes, apartments, or condos. Well, if that's you, you may want to drive through an affluent neighborhood, or if you have a really good relationship with a realtor, maybe they can get you into that home of your dreams. That way you can go inside, look at all the bedrooms, look at all the bathrooms, maybe check out the kitchen, check out the living room, and maybe it even has a pool. Next, you may be the type of person who enjoys technology. So if that's you, go to your favorite tech store. Go look at the latest TVs and smartphones and iPads and computers. Also, you may be the type of person who just doesn't really need all these materialistic things. So maybe you enjoy friends and family. So if that's you, then I want to encourage you to spend a little more time with those friends and with those family members who deserve a little more of your time. And lastly, this is for those of us who enjoy clothes, right? Ladies and gentlemen, if you really like shoes, then go to your favorite shoe store and try on a pair of shoes. If you enjoy clothes, maybe go to your favorite clothing store. Ladies, try on that dress. Fellas, try on that new suit, right? And also, don't forget to take a picture of yourself while you are enjoying your wealth experience. Now, here's the thing about all wealth experiences, regardless of what you're going to do. The purpose is not to spend a lot of money. As a matter of fact, you can get away with spending no money whatsoever. However, if you do find yourself spending money, then go right ahead, but make sure that you already have a budget set aside specifically for Wealth Day. Now, lastly, I want to address the 23% challenge diet, which really is a 7-day diet where all you're eating are plant foods and drinking water. Now, today, I want to offer you just a little more information because I do understand that some people may be questioning this diet. Where am I going to get my calcium? Where am I going to get my protein, right? So I want to go through each food group very quickly and let you know which nutrients you're providing the body. So food group number one are fruits. So if you find yourself eating a lot of fruit, you're going to be ingesting tons of fiber, lots of vitamins, lots of minerals, also lots of phytonutrients. And let's remember that most fruits are at least 50% water. So guess what? You're going to be eating, or shall I say drinking, a lot of water in addition to all those other phytochemicals. Next up are your veggies and herbs. Guys, veggies and herbs are an excellent source of fiber, vitamins, minerals, and other phytonutrients. So basically, when it comes to fruits and vegetables, they're going to provide you with the same type of nutrients, but there'll be different nutrients. Next up are your nuts and seeds. Now, when it comes to nuts and seeds, a lot of people may wonder, well, where am I going to get the majority of my calories from? And I'm also concerned about my level of fat. Well, guys, here we go. When it comes to nuts and seeds are an excellent source of unsaturated fats. Those are the good fats. So if you find yourself getting hungry and you need a little snack, don't fret. Nuts and seeds are definitely the way to go. Next up are legumes, meaning beans and peas. A lot of people may wonder, well, where am I going to get my protein from? Well, have that question no more. Legumes, beans, and peas are an excellent source of protein. So whether you like black beans, pinto beans, black-eyed peas, lima beans, the list goes on and on and on and on. Don't worry, there's lots and lots of plant protein in these plant foods. So please don't fret. And lastly, we got to talk about whole grains. Now, some of us may be athletes and we may be wondering, well, where am I going to get a lot of my carbohydrates from to fuel my endurance type of athletic performances? Well, if that's you, then don't fret about carbohydrates. Whole grains such as brown rice, quinoa, couscous, teff, spelt, they are excellent sources of carbohydrates. So if you are an endurance athlete and you need a plant-based source of high fiber carbohydrates, then whole grains are definitely the way to go. So there we have it, guys. Lots of information about Wealth Day and, of course, the 23% challenge diet. That's all that I have for you. So always remember, let's eat well, feel well, think well, do well, be well. This is your man, Coach D, signing out on Wealth Day. Take care, God bless, and never, ever forget that Coach D loves you.